Good afternoon, friends. Myself, Darshan Mehta, working as an assistant professor in Civil Engineering Department of Dr. S. and S. S. Gandhi Government Engineering College, Surat. Today, I am going to deliver lecture on turbo machinery, which is a part of Applied Fluid Mechanics subject 2160602. Now, I am going to start with the turbo machinery basic definition. That what do you mean by turbo machinery? So before starting with that, first of all, we should understand that which type of energy is present in the machine. Okay, now turbo machinery is nothing but it is a one type of a rotating device, or you can say it is a one machine, or it is a one equipment in which two type of energy is present. One is the kinetic energy and other is the potential energy. So whatever the hydraulic energy is produced, it converted into the mechanical energy. And if we talk about the turbine, then there will be the conversion of hydraulic energy into the mechanical energy. Hydraulic means it correlates with the water, it correlates with the fluid, it correlates with the fluid particles, means flow of the water, flow of a flowing fluid. And if we talk about the pump, then there will be the inverse of this particular energy, that is from mechanical to the hydraulic energy. So in simple words, if we want to understand the definition of turbo machinery, so when there is a conversion of hydraulic into mechanical in case of turbine, then it is known as the turbo machinery. And when there is a conversion of mechanical into hydraulic in case of pump, then it is known as the turbo machinery. Now if we want to remember only in the one line, then we can say conversion of water energy into the hydraulic power, or you can say electric power, is known as the turbo machinery. Basically, turbo machinery is that is a combination of two words. One is the turbo and other is the machinery. Machinery indicates there is one machine. Turbo means there is certain energy which is going to produce, and then it will get converted into some other energy. So this is the basic definition of the turbo machinery. Now next we go with the topic elements of hydroelectric power plant. As you observe on the screen in my slide, that there are two diagrams, two images which I have kept on the slide. One is of a dam in which the water is flowing or water is released from the dam on the upstream side. Means when the gates are open, water is released from the dam. And in the second diagram, it is of hydroelectric dam. That is, you can say it is the schematic diagram. It is a schematic diagram of the hydroelectric power house, or you can say hydroelectric power dam. So you just see the one animation which I have kept, that from the reservoir the water is going into the downstream side. Then at one particular point, you just see on the turbine, the energy is get converted and the gates are opened. When the gates are opened, the water is going to flow at the downstream side at the outflow of the river. So if we understand this particular image, so when the water is released from the dam, so it is on the upstream side and it reaches at a certain point, and when the gates are open, it will reach to the outflow of the river. So this is the schematic diagram. Some names are also written in this particular diagram. Reservoir, it is means these are the element, reservoir, intake structure, then penstock, then you can see that turbine, outflow of the river, powerhouse generator, and the power line. So these are the various components of the hydroelectric power plant. Fine. Now we go into the depth of each component. So these are the component of the hydroelectric power plant: reservoir, dam, trash track, forebay, surge tank, penstock, spillway, water turbine, powerhouse, and the draft tube. Now we discuss one by one. So reservoir, what is the use of reservoir? Reservoir is in the hydroelectric power plant is used to store the water. Only for storing the water we are going to keep the reservoir. Second is the dam. Dam having also the same purpose. Dam is storing the water, but it can supply, it can release, it can distribute water as per the need, as per the requirement. Fine. So reservoir only to store the water, dam to store the water and release accordingly. Third is the trash track. So trash track is nothing, but it is used to prevent debris, entry of debris means damage the fixed blade. Means whenever there is a high amount of flow or high amount of water which is flowing into through the dam. So at that time there are certain debris. Debris means some waste material. Okay. So for that we are providing the trash track which prevent the entry of debris. Means there is one obstruction and due to which the debris, the entry of the debris is prohibited, which keep our blade safe. Okay, so to prevent the debris entering into the blade, or you can say damage the fixed blade, because the blades are fixed, and whenever it will whenever there is a debris like some type of rocky material, some coarse gravel like that, so it will damage the blades. Then next is a forebay. Okay, now forebay, what do you mean by forebay? So forebay is nothing but it is a it serves as a regulating reservoir which is able to absorb the flow variation when the load on the plant reduce or the increase. Okay, so forebay is nothing but it is a you can say it served as a reservoir only. It serves as a reservoir only. Now what it works? Okay, so it regulates the reservoir which is able to absorb the flow variation. So whenever there is a variation in the flow, whenever there is a fluctuation in the flow of the water due to which the load on the plant is reduced or increased, means there is a power fluctuation, there is a load fluctuation, sometimes it may get increased, sometimes it may get decreased. So due to that we are providing the forebay structure, and due to that what it will do, it will serve as a regulating reservoir. Regulating means one additional reservoir. Then next is a surge tank. What is the use of surge tank? Surge tank is provided between the dam and the powerhouse to protect the pipeline from bursting. To protect the pipeline from the bursting due to the sudden change in the flow. Means you had started and in the initial stage the flow is very high. Okay, now when you come to know that the flow is very high, so suddenly you are going to reduce the amount of flow. So there is some fluctuation. Due to that, if there is a sudden change in the rate of the flow, there are certain problems which are going to arise. Due to that, if there is some damages, so to prevent the damages, the surge tank is introduced between the dam and the powerhouse. Means to protect the pipeline, because if you suddenly increase the flow of the water, you are not going to change the diameter of the pipe. You are just increasing the flow. So what will happen? Pipe will get burst out. Okay, so for minimizing that, for preventing the dam or for protect the pipeline, we should provide the surge tank between the dam and the powerhouse. Now next is the penstock. What is penstock? Penstock is nothing but it is a pipe. It is a one type of pipe having the large diameter which is used to carry the water having the under pressure from reservoir to the turbine. Yes, so if you increase the flow of the water, you will provide the penstock, then it will easily supply the water from the reservoir to the turbine. Next is the spillway. What is spillway? Spillway is one type of structure which is used to carry the surplus water from upstream to downstream. In other words, it is also known as a safety valve of dam. Okay. Then next is the turbine, water turbine. What do you mean by water turbine? Already I told you, when there is a conversion of potential energy into the kinetic energy, or you can say when there is a conversion of hydraulic energy into the mechanical energy, then it is known as the turbine. Next is the powerhouse. Powerhouse is the thing, but it consists of substructure to support the hydraulics and electric equipment and protect them. And last is the draft tube. What do you mean by draft tube? Discharge water from exit of the turbine to the tailless. Means whatever the amount of water is reached to the turbine, that should be supplied to the tail dress. Means discharge, you will release that water to the tail dress. So these are all the various components of hydroelectric power plant. Now we go with the classification of the turbine. So mainly the turbine is classified into four parts. Number one is the according to the energy at the inlet. Second, according to the direction of the flow of water on the runner. Then third, according to the water head and the quantity of the water available. Fourth, according to the specific speed. Okay, so we go with the according to the type of energy. So I already discussed that if there is a kinetic energy, then it is known as the impulse turbine, and we have the example, best example is the Pelton turbine.
Second is the reaction turbine. In reaction turbine, there are two types of energy, kinetic as well as the potential. The example is the Francis and the Kaplan and the propeller turbine. Second classification is according to the direction of the flow. Means which type of direction it is on the runner. Means direction of the water on the runner. So tangential flow, axial flow, radial flow and the mixed flow. Tangential flow, water strikes runner tangential to the path of the rotation of the runner. Means your runner is going to rotate. So in that, the water will going to strike. Okay. So it will be like tangential. Tangential, it will strike on the to the path of the rotation, and the example is the Pelton turbine. Axial flow, water flow in the direction parallel to the axis of the turbine, means water flowing with direction parallel, means our axis and the flowing water direction is they are parallel to each other. The example is Kaplan and the propeller turbine. Radial, water flow in the radial direction through the runner. And last is the mixed flow. Mixed flow means it is the combination of axial and radial. It means that water enters through the runner in the radial direction but leaves in the direction parallel to the axis of the rotation of the runner. It means the combination of axial and the radial. So in the mixed flow, in the starting phase, water enters through the runner in the radial direction, but when it leaves out, at that time it is in the direction to the axis of the rotation. So example is the modern Francis turbines. Francis turbine, which we all are aware, that is the normal Francis. But for this particular mixed flow, new Francis turbine, that is the modern Francis turbines, is coming into the picture. Now next is the according to the water head and the quantity of the water available, high head and the small quantity of water, medium head and the medium quantity of the water, low head and the large flow. It means you just see, when there is a high head, amount of water is less. When there is a medium head, amount of quantity is medium. And when there is a low head, then you could just see it, the large flow rate. Means the flow rate is increased, the head is less. The flow rate is less, the head is more. Okay. According to the specific speed, if the specific speed is less than 60, then you can categorize as a low specific speed turbine. If the specific speed is between 60 to 400, then you can categorize into medium specific speed. And if your specific speed is above 400, means greater than 400, then you can categorize as the high specific speed turbine. Okay. Now comparison between the impulse and the reaction turbine. Already we discussed in the previous section about the type. So I am just going to read out the points. So all available energy are converted into kinetic energy in the nozzle. Whereas in the reaction, two type of energy already I told you. Only the portion of available energy of the water partly converted into, not fully. In the impulse, all the total energy, total. In the case of the reaction, partly, means half of the energy is going to convert into the kinetic energy, but only on the fixed blade. Second, the energy is kinetic in the impulse turbine, in the reaction, kinetic as well as the potential. In the impulse turbine, water flowing through the nozzle and it is striking on the moving blades. But in the case of reaction turbine, water enters into the fixed blade and then moving into the runners. I already told you in the classification, mixed flow. Okay. Then next is a turbine installed above tail rest and there is no draft tube in the impulse turbine. But in the case of reaction, turbine installed above and below the tail rest and the draft tube is also provided. In the case of impulse, it is only provided on the upstream side. Okay, above the tail rest. Fine. Impulse turbine is possible to regulate the flow without loss. In the case of reaction, it is not possible. Then the flow regulation is done by the means of needle valve fitted into the nozzle. But in the case of a reaction turbine, the flow regulation is carried out by the means of guide vanes, means one type of blade. In impulse turbine, the work done by the change in the kinetic energy of the jet. In the case of reaction turbine, work is done partly change in velocity head, but almost by change in the pressure head also. Means two head you are going to change, then and then the work is going to be done. Fine. Now next we go to the head and efficiency of the turbine. What is the head? What is the efficiency? So there is gross head is nothing but it is the difference between the water level at the tail race, a head race, that is a reservoir, and at the level of the tail race. Means the difference between the water level, means reservoir, and the level of the tail race. As you see in the diagram, that is the HG, that is the gross head. You just see HG, this is the water reservoir and this is the tail race, head race. So difference between the water level of the head race, that is the reservoir, and the level of the tail rest. Now what do you mean by net head? Net head means the head available at the inlet of the turbine. Means water flowing from the reservoir through the pipe, there is a loss of head due to the friction between the pipe, that is penstock, and the water occur. Means head available at the inlet of the turbine means on the inlet of the turbine, whatever the head is available, that is known as the net head. And first we discuss the gross head. Gross head means total amount of water, means whatever the water which is going to release from the dam, release from the reservoir, each and every water we have to calculate. You can say that the gross means total water, means in our structure, dam, penstock, reservoir, each and everything we have to consider. But if in the case of the net head, whatever the head available at the inlet of the turbine is known as the net head. Now we go with the various definition of the efficiency. In the previous slide, we have discussed about the head. Now we go for efficiency. So there are four types of efficiency: mechanical, hydraulic, volumetric, and overall. Mechanical efficiency means ratio of power available at the shaft of turbine to the power delivered to the runner. Ratio of power available at the shaft means on the shaft of the turbine, whatever the power available to the power delivered to the runner by the water, that is known as a mechanical. Means some mechanism is going to apply to start the runner, to start the motor. Fine. Second is the hydraulic. Now in this hydraulic, water, we have to consider the water. Means the ratio of power developed at the turbine runner to the power supply at the inlet of the runner. Means whatever the power developed at the turbine runner, to the power supply at inlet of runner. Whatever the power supply at the inlet of the runner to start the motor. Volumetric efficiency, ratio of volume of water actually striking the runner to the volume of water supplied to the turbine. Means there is a huge amount of water is released from the dam, released from the reservoir, but actual water which is striking to the runner, that water to the volume of water supplied to the turbine is known as the volumetric efficiency. And last is the overall efficiency. Overall efficiency is nothing but the ratio of power available at the shaft output power to the turbine to the power supply. Means output power divided by input power give you the overall efficiency. Now we go with the Pelton turbine. What is Pelton turbine? It is most widely used turbine, impulse turbine. The speed of the turbine can be changed by varying the size of the water jet. The first turbine which is designed, Pelton turbine, in 1870s by Lester Allen Pelton. Water falls through the turbine through a pipe which is known as the penstock and flowing through the nozzle. As already we discussed in the difference of comparison of impulse and the reaction. A Pelton runner consists of single wheel mounted on the horizontal shaft. Now you just see the images. One, both the images are of the Pelton turbine. But in the second image, you just see it is noted that each and every component is noted. First, just see on the first. It is a spring balance, to balance the spring, which can help for to keep our blade proper. Second is the manometer to find out the pressure difference. Third is the adjustment of the nozzle cross section. Third, you just see the nozzle means the speed of the flow. Fourth is the needle nozzle. You just see that is the needle nozzle. Fifth is the Pelton wheel, which I told you to start the in the proper way, we have to adjust our spring balance. And sixth is the adjustment of the bend brake. That is the adjustment. If my runner is on the upstream side, then if I want to put into the downstream side, I just have to operate my blade, and because due to that we can easily control our the blades. So Pelton turbine, already I discussed you in the earlier times, the wheel design, Pelton wheel design, the runner is vertical and if rotated about the horizontal shaft, the high speed jet of the water comes out from the nozzle, hits the bucket on the runner, on the wheel, and causes the wheel to rotate, providing the torque and the power. Now what are the components of the Pelton turbine? that we will now going to discuss nozzle, runner and bucket, drinking jet and the casing. What is the use of casing? Casing is used to prevent the splashing of water from the turbine. When you start the motor, at that time the flow is at very high rate. So due to that, the water is going to splashing out from your tank. So for preventing that, we have to provide the casing in the turbine. Now how the casing is going to look? See in this, at the you just see the top portion on the upstream of the runner. There is a white color of casing. In this also the gray color, that is known as the casing. Okay. Runner and the bucket, it is consists of the circular disc. You just see runner. This is known as the runner. It is a circular disc of which the number of buckets evenly spaced are fixed. Buckets is divided into two symmetrical parts by dividing the wall known, which is known as a splitter. Braking jet. Braking jet nozzle is completely closed by moving the spear in the forward direction. The amount of water striking into the runner reduces to the zero. Nozzle increases the kinetic energy of the water flowing through the penstock. Now next we go to the application of the Pelton turbine, means where it is used. So Pelton wheel are preferred turbine for the hydropower when the available water resource is relatively very high hydraulic head at a very low rate. And depending on the water flow and the design, Pelton will operate best with a head of 15 meter to the 1800 meters, although there is no any theoretical limit. And a comparable amount of pipe material is required for each of the two sources, one required for the long thin pipe and the other is for the short thin. Now we go for the Francis turbine. It is also most commonly used reaction turbine. Essentially the pressure turbines flowing completely full and under very high pressure, hence the runner must be fully enclosed. Used for the water head between the 30 meter to the 300 meter, and in this turbine water enters into the runner of the turbine in the radial direction and leaves outlet in the axial direction in the inlet of the turbine. Now what are the main parts? In the previous we already discussed about the casing, then the runner and the bucket. Only two things are added in this, that is the guide mechanism and the draft tube. Now guide mechanism is nothing but it is one type of mechanism in which it can guide that how to operate, how to do the maintenance. So such type of things is going to be takes place in this guide mechanism. It consists of stationary circular wheel all around the runner of the turbine, and stationary guide vanes are fixed on the guide mechanism, and these vanes are operated automatically with the help of governor. It means that it will guide, and it will also possible, it will also give the mechanism that how to operate and how to do the maintenance. Draft tube is nothing. Already I told you draft tube. What is the use of draft tube? Discharge of water from the turbine to the tail race, means exit water from the runner is passed through the diverging tube, which is known as the draft tube. Okay. As the reaction turbine is under very high pressure, therefore a closed conduit is required to connect the runner exit to the tail race. So in the previous the component of hydroelectric plant, I already told you that discharging the water from the turbine to the tail race, and due to this the exit velocity is decreases and the effective head on the runner increases, and that is why the efficiency of this system is also going to increase. Now we go to the draft tube. What is draft tube? A pipe of gradually increasing area which is fitted to the outlet of the reaction. An outlet is connected to the tail race level, and the purpose is discharge water from the exit of the reaction turbine to the tail race. Water allowed to discharge freely into the atmosphere from the exit of the runner. Then the working head over the turbine or the runner will be equal to the height of the water on the runner outlet, and it is possible to establish the negative head at the outlet of the runner by amount equal to the height of the runner outlet above the tail race. Now why we are providing to the draft tube? So already I told you that for discharging the water from the turbine to the tail race, it permits the negative or the suction head to be established at the runner exit, thus making it possible to install the turbine above the tail race without any loss of head. Means if we want to install the draft tube, if you want to keep the draft tube, then we have to install that draft tube above the turbine and the tail race without the loss of head. It converts the large portion of the kinetic energy which is already rejected from the runner into the pressure energy, which act as a recuperation of the pressure energy. And use of draft tube results in very higher efficiency. It means that automatically your efficiency of the turbine is going to increase, and using draft tube net head on the turbine increases and thus develop more power and the efficiency stresses. Now what are the different types of draft tube? Straight diversion tube, moody spreading tube, simple elbow tube, then elbow tube having circular cross section. Now specific speed. What do you mean by specific speed? Specific speed is the speed geometrically similar turbine which develop the unit power when the working under head. Means whenever the turbine it is in the working condition, we can find the specific speed. How you can find? It is geometrically similar turbine which develops the unit power. Based on the unit power, we can categorize the, or we can find out the specific speed. Means unit power when working under a head. Means head is certain head. Geometrically means turbine is identical in shape, dimension, blade, angles, gate opening, etc. Now what is the equation of the specific speed? Theta is equals to shaft power divided by water power, which gives you the final equation. Eta 0 is equals to P upon rho g qh upon 1000. This equation will going to help you for solving the example. Now, significance of the specific speed. It is directly proportional to the speed. Evidently, high speed propeller type are expected to have very high specific speed. Inversely proportional to the head, high head have low specific speed. That already we discussed in the classification section. Concept of specific speed is very much useful for the selection of turbine for given set of conclusions. And the last thing is site of installation and the output required for a turbine, which are known for the specific speed, and it can be calculated through the type of machine which is suited as per the condition. Now unit quantities. What do you mean by unit quantities? When the head on the machine is unity, the quantities such as speed, discharge and power are termed as the unit quantity. Means whenever my machine is not under the working condition, it means that when the head of my machine is unity, at that time the quantities such as the speed, discharge and power are categorized as a unit quantity. Now the important unit quantity are unit speed, unit discharge and unit power. What is unit speed? Speed of turbine working under a head is known as the unit speed. Unit discharge, discharge passing through the turbine which is working under a unit head. And last is the unit power, power which is developed by the turbine under the unit head 1 meter. So you just see the definition itself says that there is something relation between the unit head 1 meter and the discharge speed and the power. So the definition itself says when the head of the machine is unity, the quantity such as speed, discharge and power are termed as a unit quantity, and that we already had discussed. Okay, now what is the performance characteristics curve? Now performance characteristics means if you are going to select the Pelter turbine, if you are going to select Francis turbine, if you are going to select the Kaplan turbine, so we must know about the performance of the particular turbine. So for that performance characteristics curve, turbine are usually designed or installed for the particular values of H, Q, P, N, head, discharge and so on, and overall efficiency, which are known as the design conditions. So these are all the design conditions that turbine usually designed or installed for a particular value H, P, then Q and N. But in the actual condition of the operation, the turbine may offer required to work at different condition for those they have designed. Fine. So performance of the turbine is obtained from the test. Means you can prepare the test and continuously you are going to take. And based on the test, you can easily judge or you can easily find out the performance of the turbine. Now we go to the ventilation system. Ventilation system is nothing but it moves outdoor air into the building or a room and distribute the air within the building. Ventilation means it is the natural air which is going to supply into the building or into the room. The general purpose of the ventilation in the building is to provide the healthy air, means healthy air atmosphere or the breathing, by both diluting the pollutants originating in the building and removing the pollutant from it. Means you have to remove all the pollutants from the building, and then afterwards you can just provide the ventilation system which can serve into the building or a room. Now building ventilation has three basic elements which are most important. One is the ventilation rate, other is the airflow direction, and third is the air distribution or the airflow pattern. Now ventilation means up to how what amount it can reach, means the amount of outdoor air that is provided into the space and the quality of the air. Means two things we are considered: amount of outdoor air and second quantity of the outdoor air. Airflow direction, in this we have to consider the direction of the airflow. The overall airflow direction in the building, which should be from clean zone to the dirty zone. Fine. And last is the air distribution or the airflow pattern. The external air should be delivered to each part of the space in an efficient manner, and the airborne pollutant generated in each part of the space should be removed. Means whatever the pollutant is present in the turbine, that should be removed in an efficient manner so that the pollutants get generated in each part of the space. There are three methods that we use to ventilate a building. One is the natural ventilation system, second is the mechanical ventilation system, and third is the hybrid, that is a combination of the natural and the mechanical ventilation system. So first, what is natural ventilation system? So we go with the ventilation, natural ventilation. Natural ventilation means natural forces like wind, thermal buoyancy force due to the indoor and the outdoor air density differences. So natural forces drive outdoor air through purpose built building envelope openings, that is the natural ventilation system. The purpose built opening include the window, doors, solar chimney, wind tower, and the trickle ventilators. This natural ventilation of the building depends upon the climate, building design, and the human behavior. Natural means the air. Then it is totally depend upon the climate. If there is a very cold weather, then we can say it is a cold natural ventilation system. Okay, so it is totally based on the climate change. Okay, that's why it is written that the natural ventilation system on the building is depend upon the building design, then climate, and the human behavior. As we all know that whenever we are going to construct a building, whenever we are going to plan a building, we must aware that on which side the air is going to come, which side the sunset. Okay, so based on that, the building can be designed. So the natural ventilation system of the building depends upon the climate, building design, and the human behavior. Now, what do we mean by the mechanical ventilation system? Mechanical ventilation system, we are going to provide some mechanical equipment like fan, AC, then tower fan, then we can say the cooler. So these are all the mechanical ventilation system. Mechanical fans drive the mechanical ventilation system. It can neither be installed directly into the window or the wall. You all are aware that window AC, in the previous few years back, there is a window AC. Nowadays there is a split AC which having the inverters inside the we are installing the that split AC inside our home or in the room. Okay, so fan can either be installed directly into the window or the wall, or installed in air duct for supplying the air into or exhausting air from a room. This type of mechanical ventilation system is totally depend upon the climate. If you feel hot, then you are going to start the AC. If you are feeling the cold, then you are not going to start the AC. Means it totally depend upon the climate of that particular place. For example, in the warm and the humid climate, infiltration may need to be minimized or prevented to reduce the interstitial condensation. Fine. A balanced mechanical ventilation system refers to the system where air supply and exhaust have been tested and adjusted to the meet design the specification. Now, what is hybrid? I already told you, hybrid is nothing but is a combination of two, that is the natural and the mechanical ventilation system. It uses mechanical ventilation when the natural ventilation flow rate is very low. Means when they will use the mechanical ventilation system when the flow rate of the when the rate of the natural ventilation system being low. When the natural ventilation system alone is not suitable, exhaust fan can be installed to increase the ventilation rate in the room housing patients with the airborne infection. Problem associated with the use of exhaust fan include the installation, difficulties, noise increased or decreased temperature in the room, and the requirement for the non-stop electricity supply. Means problem associated with the use of exhaust fan include the installation difficulties, this noise, and these means problem that are so much common. Means they associated with the use of fans, means the difficulty phase in the installation, then the noise while doing the installing, noise increase sometime, it will get decrease, temperature in the room, and you can say the requirement of the non-stop electricity supply. So this is about the ventilation system types, that is the natural ventilation system and the mechanical ventilation system, and last is the hybrid ventilation system. Hybrid means it is the combination of 2, that is the natural and the mechanical ventilation system. So in this particular chapter we had discussed about the introduction of the turbo machinery, then what are the components of the hydroelectric power plant, then we also had studied about the turbine, that what are the different types of turbine, classification of the turbine, then the difference between the impulse turbine and the reaction turbine, then we also go with the discussion with the Pelton turbine and the Francis turbine in detail, then we go for a head at the efficiency of the turbine. Okay, so these are all the topic which we have discussed today in this present lecture, and at last we have discussed about the ventilation system, that what exactly the ventilation system is and what are the various type like natural, mechanical and the mix. Mix is the hybrid mechanical system. Fine, so I hope you enjoyed the lecture and thank you for listening me. Thanks for your patience. Thank you so much.